won the Lakewood medal. It was awesome. Yeah. Vocalist, best vocalist.
Best vocalist.
I wish it were liquid because it's heavier than
that. Yeah, it is, right?
Probably have like some sort of card to help.
Yeah. Or even one more card to run around. Yeah, absolutely.
Right?
I would, absolutely. Honestly, I mean, as a fan, if you don't mind me gushing a little bit, I am hard put to find anyone in this day and age who does it better than Mr. Dio right here. Right? And just as powerful today as you were then, and I couldn't see anyone more deserving. So
thank you, Corey. Thank you so much, man. And super respect goes back to you too, right? Absolutely. You know, I know how good you were too.
No, thank you.
It's beautiful here, man. A lot of things, you know, Corey tells us.
We're gonna kiss. We're gonna kiss it.
You know what, bro?
This is really cool because I met Corey for the first time tonight, personally. Yeah. And it's really cool for me to make another friend, especially one who's respected as much as Corey. So I have some idea of what I mean. So this is really cool. He's my partner.
I'm starting to blush. You know, you're an inspiration to so many people right now, dude. And what you did recently on video, and just that people to see that and to realize the hope that you're giving so many people.
Well, it's a real thing. You know, I never realized that before. Before this, touched my life, my life was in a different place. Hey, I was like drinking and, doing all the great things that we all do. I mean, you don't think about any alternatives. And then when this, came down on me like a ton of bricks, my whole life changed, obviously. And my whole opinion of life changed. My opinion of people changed. Oh, I love you. And they've been so wonderful to me. But that's what's opened my eyes to everything. How much people really, really do care about you.
Yeah.
That's what it's down to how good a person you are, I think, is all. I'm trying to be a good guy all my life, and be friendly and nice, and not think so much of myself. And I think it's paid off. But this has been a very, very big life-changing experience for me. And I'm on the bandwagon now. I'll spend the rest of my life helping people who have the same affliction I need.
Good afternoon, everybody. How you doing? All right? I'm Eddie Trunk, and it's an honor for me to be here once again, just about 5 years after we first lost Ronnie, to host the memorial service this afternoon. What you just saw up there on that screen was the last interview Ronnie ever did, and if there ever needed to be more of a testament to the man's greatness, just take a look to know what he was going through at that time, and his spirit and his willingness still to give back is simply incredible. You know, just down from the hotel where I'm staying, I passed by a restaurant the other day that I did my last ever interview with Ronnie. It was for the bonus features on the Heaven and Hell DVD, a Moroccan restaurant, and Wendy had me come out to do it. And, I'll never forget, he was dealing with so much. He showed me had a little valve in his heart where he was getting treatment, but he uplifted everybody that day. And that's something that Ronnie did consistently throughout his career with all the people that he met and all the people that he touched. And we had a great time at bowling last night. Was anybody at bowling? Wendy says she wanted to keep things light today and celebratory, so I'll tell you that I bowled a 60. A 6-0. But it's not about what you bowled, it's about